Very good evening and welcome to the parish church of St Mary Redcliffe. My name's Dan Tindall, the vicar of the parish, and it is very good to have you here for this Songs of Sadness and Gladness. She stayed at the side of Jesus when he died. She was the first witness of his empty tomb. And she's mentioned more times in the New Testament than most of the apostles. And yet there has always been controversy about the woman known as Mary Magdalene, Mary from Magdala. We know that she was not the sinful woman whose sins the Lord forgave, as has been thought for many years. Indeed, modern scholarship has restored the understanding of her as one of the most important early Christian leaders. So it is fascinating that Jonathan Bielby, in his new work, Seven Last Words from the Cross, has given the narrator's part not to a male character, but to Mary Magdalene, the apostle to the apostles. His piece leaves Christ on the cross with Magdalene in floods of tears, heartbroken. But sadness turns into gladness as Mary meets her risen Saviour in the garden, surely the most wonderful scene in the Bible. And she knows that her Redeemer lives, and we all rejoice with her. Hallelujah. Tuesday of this week is the feast day of St. Mary Magdalene. So let us pray. Almighty God, whose Son restored Mary Magdalene to health of mind and body, and called her to be a witness to his resurrection, forgive our sins and heal us by your grace, that we may serve you in the power of his risen life, who is alive and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, now and forever. Amen. Now will you please welcome our two soloists, Charlotte Newstead and Niall Hoskin, and Jonathan Bielby to conduct the first performance of Seven Last Words from the Cross.
I tell you, today you will be with me in paradise.
Thank you.
early on the first day of the week, while it was still dark, Mary Magdalene came to the tomb and saw that the stone had been removed from the tomb. So she ran and went to Simon Peter and the other disciple, the one whom Jesus loved, and said to them, "They have taken away the Lord out of the tomb, and we do not know where they have laid him." Then Peter and the other disciple set out and went toward the tomb. The two were running together, but the other disciple outran Peter and reached the tomb first. He bent down to look in, saw the linen wrappings lying there, but he didn't go in. Then Simon Peter came, following him, and he went into the tomb. He saw the linen wrappings lying there and the cloth that had been on Jesus' head, not lying with the linen wrappings, but rolled up in a place by itself. Then the other disciple, the one who reached the tomb first, also went in, and he saw and believed. For as yet they did not understand the scripture that Jesus must rise from the dead. Then the disciples returned to their homes, but Mary stood weeping outside the tomb. And as she wept, she bent over to look into the tomb, and she saw two angels in white sitting where the body of Jesus had been lying, one at the head and the other at the foot. They said to her, "Woman, why are you weeping?" She said to them, "They have taken away my Lord, and I don't know where they have laid him." When she'd said this, she turned round and saw Jesus standing there, but she didn't know that it was Jesus. And Jesus said to her, "Woman, why are you weeping? For whom are you looking?" Supposing him to be the gardener, she said to him, "Sir, if you have carried him away, tell me where you have laid him, and I will take him away." Jesus said to her, "Mary?" She turned and said to him in Hebrew, "Rabboni," which means teacher. Jesus said to her, "Do not hold on to me, because I have not yet ascended to the Father. But go to my brothers and say to them, I am ascending to my Father and your Father, to my God and your God." Mary Magdalene left the garden and said,
"Oh,
in the twinkling of an eye. At the last trumpet, trumpet shall sound, and the dead shall be raised, and the dead shall be raised incorruptible, the trumpet shall sound, and the dead shall be raised incorruptible, be raised incorruptible, and we shall be
May Christ, who out of defeat brings a new hope and a new future, fill you with new life. And the blessing of God, who is Father, Son, and Holy Spirit, be with you this night and forevermore. Amen. Amen. Good evening and welcome to the Parish Church of St Mary Redcliffe. My name's Dan Tyndall, the Vicar of the Parish, and it is very good to have you here for this Songs of Sadness and Gladness. She stayed at the side of Jesus when he died. She was the first witness of his empty tomb, and she's mentioned more times in the New Testament than most of the Apostles. And yet there has always been controversy about the woman known as Mary Magdalene, Mary from Magdala. We know that she was not the sinful woman whose sins the Lord forgave, as has been thought for many years. Indeed, modern scholarship has restored the understanding of her as one of the most important early Christian leaders. So it is fascinating that Jonathan Bielby, in his new work, Seven Last Words from the Cross, has given the narrator's part not to a male character, but to Mary Magdalene, the apostle to the apostles. His piece leaves Christ on the cross with Magdalene in floods of tears, heartbroken. But sadness turns into gladness as Mary meets her risen Saviour in the garden, surely the most wonderful scene in the Bible. And she knows that her Redeemer lives, and we all rejoice with her, hallelujah. Tuesday of this week is the feast day of St. Mary Magdalene. So let us pray. Almighty God, whose Son restored Mary Magdalene to health of mind and body and called her to be a witness to his resurrection, forgive our sins and heal us by your grace, that we may serve you in the power of his risen life, who is alive and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, now and forever. Amen. Now will you please welcome our two soloists, Charlotte Newstead and Niall Hoskin, and Jonathan Bielby to conduct the first performance of Seven Last Words from the Cross. first day of the week, while it was still dark, Mary Magdalene came to the tomb and saw that the stone had been removed from the tomb. So she ran and went to Simon Peter and the other disciple, the one whom Jesus loved, and said to them, "They have taken away the Lord out of the tomb, and we do not know where they have laid him." Then Peter and the other disciple set out and went toward the tomb. The two were running together, but the other disciple outran Peter and reached the tomb first. He bent down to look in, saw the linen wrappings lying there, but he didn't go in. Then Simon Peter came, following him, and he went into the tomb. He saw the linen wrappings lying there and the cloth that had been on Jesus' head, not lying with the linen wrappings, but rolled up in a place by itself. Then the other disciple, the one who reached the tomb first, also went in, and he saw and believed. For as yet they did not understand the scripture that Jesus must rise from the dead. Then the disciples returned to their homes, but Mary stood weeping outside the tomb. And as she wept, she bent over to look into the tomb, and she saw two angels in white sitting where the body of Jesus had been lying, one at the head and the other at the foot. They said to her, "Woman, why are you weeping?" She said to them, "They have taken away my Lord, and I don't know where they have laid him." When she'd said this, she turned round and saw Jesus standing there, but she didn't know that it was Jesus. And Jesus said to her, "Woman, why are you weeping? For whom are you looking?" Supposing him to be the gardener, she said to him, "Sir, if you have carried him away, tell me where you have laid him, and I will take him away." Jesus said to her, "Mary?" She turned and said to him in Hebrew, "Rabboni," which means teacher. Jesus said to her, "Do not hold on to me, because I have not yet ascended to the Father. But go to my brothers and say to them, I am ascending to my Father and your Father, to my God and your God." Mary Magdalene left the garden and said, "Shall stand at a
moment, in the twinkling of an eye. At the last trumpet. Trumpet shall sound, and the dead shall be raised, and the dead shall be raised incorruptible. The trumpet shall sound, and the dead shall be raised, be raised incorruptible, be raised incorruptible, and we shall be
Christ, who out of defeat brings a new hope and a new future, fill you with new